receive for employment. Hallelujah. And at this time, we're almost done. We're going to give time for the bishop to speak. But we just want to read some of the history before they play the video. Since Bishop Wayne Harris was born in Phoenix, Arizona, that would be out of date. Phoenix, Arizona, to Hayward and Daniel Harris on May 11, 1967. He is the youngest of eight children. Early in his childhood, the family relocated to Salem, Oregon with his mother. Bishop Wade, as he is affectionately called, accepted Christ at the age of 12. He attended Auburn Elementary, Parrish Middle School, and graduated in the class of 1985 from North Salem High School. Northeast Bridge Bible College in Portland, Oregon. He accepted his call into ministry at the age of 21 under the leadership of Pastor Bernard Eames of Greater Creek Christian Center, Church of God Christ of Salem, Oregon, and has been on the battlefield for the Lord ever since. Come on, let's put our hands together for a true man of God. That he know that only through Christ that all this is possible. And we just give God and we magnify his name. Video.
Given us the vision to move forward and also given us the resources. minister to those people. And also, helping to restore people back to where God wants them to be. I think that's one of our major accomplishments that we've accomplished throughout the years. For over 22 years, we've been doing a restoration conference, and throughout that conference, we've been able to restore people. We recently did it in Arizona, which was a great turnout, and we just thank God that we're able to do that, and also restore community, be able to help people get homes. Throughout the years, we've helped over 40 people get homes that would not be able to afford homes. And we thank God that we're able to do that and to build our kingdom, build God's kingdom, and build our neighborhoods at the same time. The fourth thing is advancing God's kingdom through mental health, drug and alcohol, and also to the disabled and the homeless. We have been able to advance God's kingdom through evangelism in a different way. Not just hanging on the streets and witnessing, but we've actually been able to demonstrate and mentor and minister to people. Not from the beginning of our ministry, we've opened a boys' home that we raised over 50 young men that were at risk, and God really blessed and moved. Many of them have moved on in their careers, and I was able to adopt three of the young men. The fourth one is, I believe it's one of my greatest accomplishments. And that was happened this last year, May 23rd. That was when I got married to a great woman of God, Evangelist Evelyn McCoy, now Evelyn Harris, who walks beside me in ministry. And I thank God for her and her kids, and I thank God for our family that we're able to minister as a whole to the community, not just to a certain population, but we're able to minister to the families in a totally different way. We thank God for that. And my sixth accomplishment, I believe, is developing a program called the Well Able Program, where in the WHOM Outreach Ministries, Wade Harris Outreach Ministries on Middlemont Center Drive, where we're able to do drug and alcohol, a wellness center, where we're doing counseling, where we're doing a closed closet. We currently have Mother Lofton's Food Bank, and currently is getting ready to do WHOM, Wade Harris Outreach Ministries Food Bank, and also classes to kids and outreach after school programs. And I just believe God is just getting ready to do some awesome, awesome things. And my last accomplishment, I believe that one of the greatest ones was through Seed of Faith Ministries and the businesses that we currently operate, God has allowed us to pay in full this last week on Albany property. We've purchased it 3 years ago under land sales contract. And in the last 3 years, we've completely paid off. We thank God for that accomplishment, because we did not have to tax the people. We did not have to take tithes and offering, but God allowed us to pay it off without tackling or messing with the budget of the church. And I believe that was a great accomplishment, and I believe God's going to do that for the other four locations that we have. And so, and I believe that is the biggest accomplishment, the seven biggest accomplishments that Seed of Faith has had through the 20 years. The last thing, the last question is, what is the future of Seed of Faith Ministries? Well, I can say this, that Seed of Faith Ministries, one of the things that we're getting ready to do, and it's in the works now, is we're getting ready to do the Seeds of Promise Development Center, which is our daycare center and our gymnasium on 1240 Winter Street. And we're getting ready to open that up, and we're putting things in line for that ministry to happen, to be able to do daycare and learning centers for over 200 kids at one time. And so that is going to be a great accomplishment. And the next one is developing Seed of Faith Community Housing Center on 5180 Center Street, where we've been having a problem for a while, and now God has allowed us the doors to open up where we can house people and be able to open that facility. We want at least 17 homes on that. So we believe God's going to open us the great doors. And lastly, I believe the greatest thing that God wants us to do in the near future is to pay off all of our buildings and our properties in full, that we can be debt free, that we can open up the finances to Seed of Faith Ministries to minister, not just in Salem, not just in Portland, not just in Albany, once again, I want to tell the audience, thank you for coming out to help celebrate 20 years of production. It's not one person, but it's all of us working together to build God's kingdom and advance God's kingdom in prayer. Once again,
so at this time, it is offering time in the building. Come up.